Hello there.
Okay, you can go. I figured the final video of the year deserved a special slide, so thank you for our little co-host this morning. Speaking of which, this is indeed the last video of the year. I mentioned this in our midweek video, but I'm gonna go on a little two-week sabbatical. I'm gonna go enjoy the holidays, and if you are celebrating any holidays, or even if you're just getting some much-needed time off, I hope you enjoy it as well. I will be back here, I'll meet you back here, on December 7th, which is going to be Friday. In the meantime, there will be shorts, there will be TikToks, there will be things on Instagram. There will just be no like main, like long form videos. Take a little break from that. Got some projects in the meantime, and honestly, I wanna go sit in a cafe. I just wanna enjoy myself. So that's what I will be doing for the next 2 weeks, and I will see you soon. However, we have a video today. I thought it should be kind of a cursed bang, just to kind of round off this year of madness. Now, I appreciate all of you commending my coffee weirdness that happens here, because one of my videos was actually nominated for a spreadsheet, which is blows my mind. It was the I tried every coffee product at Trader Joe's, so you don't have to. If you remember, that was a 30-minute monster of a video that left me literally on the floor. There is absolutely no good reason that that should have been nominated for a spreadsheet, but it was, and I'm very grateful. I'm also up for like social media, like coffee content of the year, which is super cool. So there are a ton of wonderful, just absolutely amazing creators on the entirety of the Spreadgy list. Fantastic cafes, producers, all sorts of things. And Spreadge is great. So if you would like to do any sort of voting or endorsing of my strangeness that happens here, I will link that down in the description below. Now, when deciding what to do for the very last video of the year here today, I had some thoughts. And these thoughts stemmed from a combination of what we did about a week ago with testing out whether you can brew coffee in a coffee brewer with milk, and also a longtime channel I've watched, Good Mythical Morning, and their series, Will It?, where they ask, will this food item or will this thing work in this other process that it is not generally associated with? They will make all sorts of things, they will taste it, and they will decide, will blank do blank, essentially. I thought we would play a little game today called Will It Coffee. And if any of you have watched Good Mythical Morning, you know exactly where I'm going with this. For those who haven't, you are in for a treat. And for all of you who were repulsed by last week's video of brewing coffee with milk, strap in your seatbelt because it gets worse. You know, just normal coffee liquids. We are going to be replacing the water aspect of a brewed coffee with the things I have in front of me here today, leaving us to answer the questions, will Red Bull coffee? Will green tea coffee? Will orange juice coffee? And last but definitely not least, will eggnog coffee? I think we are gonna taste some interesting things. I think we're gonna experience some interesting textures. And I think we should just get started, because at this point, I am only delaying the inevitable like strangeness that is gonna happen over my palate today. While I go get our little coffee maker, our poor sacrificial coffee maker all set up, I wanna give a huge thank you to the people who are sponsoring this absolutely bonkers video that we're doing today. I wanna give a huge thank you to Vessi for partnering with me on today's video. I've been wearing Vessis for a while, and they've fast become some of my favorite shoes to wear anywhere from work to my everyday. I wear their weekend model a lot, but they recently released their everyday Move, and it's fast becoming my go-to with added support and extra comfort for a sportier look. And since I live in Oregon, which if you haven't heard is quite the rainy state in the winter, I have to talk about one of my all-time favorite features about this shoe, which is that Vessis are 100% waterproof and made from a lightweight Dymatex knit material, meaning that when mistakes, spills, and more often than not puddles happen, my feet stay dry. This makes them both the perfect barista shoe and the perfect everyday rainy weather shoe. And their herringbone tread pattern helps them be grippy and safe even when I'm slipping around the cafe. So if you want to match with me and get your own pair of Vessis for yourself or even a loved one this holiday season, I gotcha. Because Vessi is giving my subscribers $25 off your purchase when you click the link below and enter code MDC. That's the link in the description, and thank you again to Vessi for your support on this channel and on my feed.
I think I definitely owe Black & Decker some sort of like apology for what I do with their machines, but they're very useful in this way, so thank you to them. I've also got 4 equivalent amounts of ground coffee that we'll be using here today. We do need to strategize a tiny bit though, because all of these liquids have a very different like texture, density, and viscosity to them. And we discovered this a little bit when we were using whole milk to brew with a week ago, that whole milk does not work and react the same way that water does. It is so much thicker. It takes a longer time moving through the coffee. It takes a longer time getting pulled up into the piping after it's been heated in the coffee machine. It's a different liquid altogether, which is the exact same thing as what we have here. We will be brewing all of these through this machine. I'm gonna do extensive cleaning in between each round, but that being said, we do need to think about the order of how we're going to brew. I would like to brew with our liquids that are closest to water first and then move towards our much thicker and maybe even slightly pulpy liquids at the end. So with that being said, we're gonna start off with our green tea to find out if that coffees. Then we're gonna move on to Red Bull. We're then gonna do our orange juice and we will finish off with our eggnog, which is arguably gonna be the thickest of all of these liquids. Don't worry though, you won't have to stick around for the cleaning portion. We'll just do that in between and then we'll move on to the next thing. One last thing before we jump into this, there will inevitably be a little bit of like cross-contamination between beverages that I'm gonna be brewing. I hesitate to say coffee, so I'm gonna say beverages, because while I'll be running cleaning cycles in this in between the different brews, there will be some residue left over, but there's gonna be like very little waiting time in between each brew. So I think it's gonna be okay. And I think if there is a tiny bit of Red Bull that like sneaks into our orange juice, I don't think it's gonna be the end of the world, because while yes, this is for science, none of this is scientific. So it is what it is, let's get going. Now, as far as our first liquid goes, this is green tea, and the question we are asking is, will green tea coffee? And I'm feeling more positively about this one than I am any of those. I think this one has a pretty good potential of being kind of good, honestly. So, without further ado, this also doesn't look nearly as wrong as any of these others are going to. I think we're starting off in a very safe place. All right, friend, do your worst. Our first drops have started. So far, it appears like we're going somewhat in the right direction. The tea we're using today does have some added sugars to it, but besides that, it is a blend of green tea, lemongrass, and spearmint. So it doesn't sound altogether unpleasant. I will say mint and coffee, as far as like black coffee is sometimes an interesting combination, but I could see it going well. The smells that are happening right now are getting to be a little interesting though. I would describe what my kitchen smells like right now as being very like grassy. Like it kind of smells like a freshly mowed lawn right now. Our green tea coffee seems to be done. So color wise, we're looking okay. It might be a little light for a cup of coffee, but other than that, it does not look un-coffee beverage like. The smell is not nearly as grassy now. I don't even really get as strong of a smell of like spearmint as I would expect to, because that really does seem to be the dominant flavor in this tea. We'll give it a test though. If this is the one that I had the highest hopes for, I am suddenly infinitely more nervous about the ones that I didn't have high hopes for. That is not great. That is not wonderful and delicious like I was hoping it would be. There's something a little sickly about this combination, at least in the form that it's in right now. Maybe when it cools, it'll be better, because that's a thing that sometimes happens. Okay, I'll be back in a second. I need to go clean this. Now, this next one we have is, I think, arguably going to be the most powerful out of everything we have, because this is Red Bull and it's an energy drink, which means it already has caffeine in it. And I've actually never had Red Bull before, because shocking as it is, as much as I enjoy coffee, I've never really gotten into energy drinks. So this will be a first for me in many ways as well. To be clear, this has 189 milligrams of caffeine in it, and it's also carbonated. That should play an interesting thing in this mix. I feel like I should apologize to my coffee as well. I feel like I should apologize to a lot of people for this video, if I'm being completely honest. I also wanna kinda just try the Red Bull. When I was at the store and I bought this, by the way, I bought like all these things at once. The cashier did give me kind of a funny look, and all she commented on was, wow, that's a lot of Red Bull. And I really didn't have the heart to tell her that I was buying it to take it home to brew coffee with, because that would have been a lot to explain. And I just figured I should just nod and say, yes, it is a lot of Red Bull indeed. Ooh. That is sweeter than I expected it to be. Not nearly as carbonated though, interestingly enough. It's kind of like a soda. I'm not a huge soda person, but I could see how people would enjoy this. In you go. This right here, this is gonna be like the thumbnail photo. I think what this reminds me of is like a melted down Jolly Rancher. That's the flavor I'm getting out of this. Our first drops are happening. Timing wise, we are looking all right so far, which is what I was expecting for both the green tea and the Red Bull, because their liquids have the most similar density to water, which you would usually be using in a machine like this. I think the orange juice and the eggnog are gonna do some strange things, because texturally and density wise and viscosity wise, they're very different than water. But as of right now, We're looking good. As good as one can, one brewing Red Bull through a coffee machine.
So, what do you think about what I'm doing right now? Opinions? Will it be good?
It smells not so bad.
I hate to say this, but that doesn't actually taste that bad.
This is not so bad. It feels like I need a whisper. It feels like I'm telling you a secret. This is kind of okay. I'll be totally honest. I am shocked at how okay those two flavors are together. Now, this doesn't taste really like coffee, at least not yet. Granted, the drink is still very hot. It mostly tastes like a very like sweet, like melted down candy with like a little bit of bitterness at the end from the coffee. It's not the worst thing I've ever drank, I'll tell you that much, jazz hands. Now we do need to let it cool for a little bit and we have two more drinks to make, but off the bat, Red Bull coffee is infinitely better than green tea does. Now I said the Red Bull beverage was gonna be the most powerful out of all of them. I think the orange juice one is gonna be the most feared out of all of them. When I was at the grocery store, I had the decision of whether I was gonna get pulped or no pulp orange juice. And I have gratefully gone with the decision that our orange juice today is gonna be pulp free. At least that's what it claims. With it, I do anticipate quite a bit of like resistance getting through the coffee and the filter and everything. I also anticipate the heat that this is gonna reach is gonna make this a very, very unpleasant drink. We got away with it with the Red Bull and with the green tea because I think for the most part, those are very like water-based, which makes it okay to heat it up to, you know, like 180 or even like 190 degrees. However, with this one, we'll just see. I have my suspicions. Can you imagine going to like a hotel or like a coffee shop or something and looking at their brewer and seeing this color in the water chamber? I can't. But now I have that memory permanently ingrained in my head. Sometimes I think about the fact that there are baristas out there training to be world barista champions. And I am out here putting orange juice in my coffee maker. Just something to think about. First contact has been made. Liquid is leaving the brewing chamber. You know, we're a little ways in and this is actually going a lot better than I was expecting it to. I was expecting the brew time on this to take a lot longer than the tea and Red Bull did just because of like the viscosity of this liquid, but it's actually going at about the same rate, which I think is a good thing. I don't think we'll be able to say that about the eggnog as we weren't able to say that about the milk, but with the orange juice, we're doing better than expected. We're starting to get the orange smell though, like some burnt orange smell. I think I'll call this drink Citrus on Fire. Okay, yummy, yummy. I take back what I said. This is a different color. This is a good deal different than what we brewed before. I think I was being a little bit too positive before. As you can see, it has a much like milkier color than either of the other two do. Okay, smell wise, doesn't smell good. I do not give Citrus on Fire a 10 out of 10. I give Citrus on Fire a 0 out of 10. But you know, that review could change. We're gonna let that cool. We're gonna brew coffee with eggnog. Now, coffee with eggnog could be all right. I mean, eggnog lattes are a very, very popular holiday drink. And in fact, adding eggnog to, let's say, a black coffee is a nice little creamer addition with a little festive twist. Personally, my favorite way to do eggnog is, let's say you have like a chai concentrate that you would usually dilute like a 1-to-1 ratio with whole milk. Instead of doing that, dilute it with eggnog. It is delicious. It's a wonderful like spiced eggnog and I think it's tasty.
What's up?
I know it does. You can't see him, or I don't think hear him right now. My partner is poking his head out of the office and like retching at the smell that's occurring in the house right now. I'm so sorry. Do you want to try it?
Oh my god.
Anyways, eggnog. First contact has been made though. We do have touchdown. We do have something that's been created here. Something that is eggnoggy and coffee-like and latte-like in color. After that orange juice one, my soul does feel a little bit crushed right now. So I'm hoping this is the one that picks us back up. I mean, hang on, I gotta go back. This has not rejuvenated my soul, but it hasn't continued in the crushing. This has some of the similar problems that our whole milk did. I do get some burnt milk flavor. I get a little bit of like, kind of like acidic, like bitterness that's not from the coffee. It's from the fact that these like proteins have started to break down. But the sweetness and the texture does so much when paired with the coffee. This is all right. This is very much okay out of all these. However, I think we need to try everything again. I think we need to give everyone a fair rating, and I think we need need to decide which of these liquids, if any, will coffee. So, working our way over from this side to this side, we have green tea, Red Bull, orange juice, and eggnog. Go for a second pass and decide if it will coffee. I can say with the surest of sures that in this format, will green tea coffee? No. I might get strung out over the coals for this, but I have to say, will Red Bull coffee? It kind of does. Maybe it's just because it was compared to such a monstrosity as the sweet green tea one, but Red Bull kind of works. That sounds terrible, but it's mostly that like warm sweetness. It tastes like melted Jolly Ranchers, and there's a little bit of bitterness on the end, and it's not too bad. Now, is this more caffeine than I think anyone should ever have in one singular drink? Yes, but does it work? Kinda. I don't want to try the orange juice one again. I'll be honest, there's a pit in my stomach thinking about tasting that again. Orange juice does not coffee. Let's be very clear about that right here and now. There is no world where orange juice coffees. Orange and citrus in coffee, however, very good, very delicious, and frequently a wonderful pairing. However, orange juice brewed coffee is gonna be a no in my book, and I don't think you need to try that to know that yourself. Now we have the eggnog though. At least we're finishing on somewhat of a high note, I think. Does eggnog coffee? Well, I don't think eggnog should coffee in your coffee pot, but I think besides that, yes, eggnog does coffee. I think you should add some eggnog to your coffee once it has been brewed with water and you will have a wonderful time. I think I need to go lay on the floor for a little bit. This was quite a time. I usually say I hope this was educational for you at the end of my videos. I don't know what I'm supposed to say about this because I don't think anyone was asking for these combinations, but I'm glad we tried them because as I said before, this is for science, even if we are not being scientific. So this was the final video for my channel for this year. This was quite a time. This was quite a mess. I think we had a pretty good time overall. Now I'm going to go head off. I'm gonna lay on the floor and then I'm gonna take the next 2 weeks to go traipse around to all the different cafes and drink all their wonderful seasonal, just delicious wintry drinks. That is my plan. I hope you also have an equally wonderful plan ahead of you for the holiday season. And I will see you here very soon, not next week and not the week after that, but very soon after that. In the meantime, as I mentioned before, you are able to get all fun links down below of places to find me, whether it's TikTok or Instagram or Twitter. You can also check out new merch drop. We still have the coffee plant design live and it's very fun and I love wearing it, as well as any other fun links I might want to include below, including Vessies and all that good stuff. Out of all of these, I think I will go drink a tiny bit more of my eggnog coffee and I will see you next time. Have a great holiday season, everyone. Have a great day, have a great week. Yeah, goodbye.